Have you had problems while blending cream or stick eyeshadows? Then this tutorial will come in handy. Hi everyone, it's Smitha. Welcome back. Today I'm going to be showing you several tips and tricks on blending cream and stick eyeshadows so you can up your blending game. So if you're ready, let's begin. Tip number one, use very little eyeshadow primer on your lid as a base while applying cream eyeshadows. Never use a concealer as a base while using cream and stick eyeshadows because they're going to mix with the concealer and sometimes they won't even show. Today I'm going to be using the Smashbox eyeshadow primer. I'm going to be using it in areas where I'll be using the eyeshadow basically on my lid as well as lower lash line. For eyeshadows, I'm going to be using the Caviar Stick eyeshadows. These are from Laura Mercier. They have some really good choices and they also have them in metallics, shimmers, as well as mattes. I'm going to start with this beautiful shade called Bed of Roses and I'm going to saturate my entire lid with it. As you can see, that glides on so smoothly. In the outer corner, I'm going to be using magenta, again, a stunning color. And with my finger, I'm going to quickly diffuse it. You can also use a brush if you like, but fingers are the most effective when it comes to cream and stick eyeshadows. Right above that, I'm going to be using ginger, again quickly diffusing it with my finger. It looks fantastic by itself, but when it comes to transition shades, it's best to set it with a powder eyeshadow. I'm going to be using Buffed. This is from the Heathered palette from Bare Minerals. You can use any light color transition shade. I'm going to go right over that transition, especially focusing on the edge where it melts into my skin tone. And I'm doing this because sometimes cream eyeshadows can leave a sharp edge even after blending, and the powder eyeshadows will smooth that out. I'm using magenta again to deepen the outer corner and in my lower lash line, and I'm going to diffuse it out with my finger. You can stop at this, apply a coat of mascara and call it done, but I just want to take it a step further. I'm going to be using the Dazzle Stick from KVD in the shade Electro Bolt right in the center of the lid. So that is going to add that pop of highlight, making the lid space look so much bigger and brighter. In my lash line, I'm going to be using Forbidden Rose, and then I'm going to smudge it out to get that smoky effect. And to deepen the very outer lash line, I'm going to be using the Aqua Resist Pencil by Makeup Forever in black. And then again, I'm going to smudge it out to get that beautiful ombre smoky effect. And then using rose gold, I'm going to highlight the inner corner. It's time to finish up, so I'm going to curl my lashes and apply a coat of mascara. For mascara, I'm going to be using the Roller Lash Mascara. This is by Benefit Cosmetics. And here's the completed eye look. It's so quick and so easy to use shadow sticks especially, and to blend it out, if it is done right, it gets done within 5 minutes, and you can create entire bridal eye looks just by using shadow sticks or cream eyeshadows. Because the eye look is so stunning, striking, and dramatically intense, I decided to do a nude lip to balance it out. I'm going to be using What's Your Sign? This is a matte lipstick by Urban Decay. And over that, I'm going to be using the lip gloss in Name Drop. And yes, my friends, I cut my hair again. I love the style. I love this length. It's so much more easier to maintain. And I feel like it looks so much more stylish. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comment section. I hope this tutorial was helpful. Please thumbs up if you enjoyed it. And if you're new here, please consider subscribing if you want to watch more videos like these. In my description box, you'll find all the products that I use today, along with my social media links in case you plan to follow me there. I love you guys so much, and I will see you soon with a brand new one. Bye, guys.